Heatset inserts aren't just oddly satisfying to install, they also add a ton of value to your 3D printed parts. They provide real metal threads in any plastic print, giving you a stronger and more durable connection, especially if you need to tighten and loosen your connection more than once. There's also no doubt that parts with threaded inserts simply look better and more professional. But what if you need to remove them because you used the wrong size, want to reuse them in another project, or plan to recycle your leftover prints through a service like the Recycling Fabrik that we have here in Germany? We've been selling threaded inserts in every size imaginable at cnckitchen.store for several years, and we believe we have a great solution. This is our new insert extractor. Over the years, I've tried several techniques for removing inserts. Some work to a point, while others can even ruin your tools. We brainstormed a number of ideas and ended up with a solution that's simple yet also not completely trivial. If you've already browsed our online store or even use our inserts, you probably know that we sell special installation tips for practically any soldering iron to make installation easier and more precise. All of these installation tip sets come with an adapter featuring an M5 thread at the end, which is used to screw on the different sizes of installation tips. The insert remover is just another accessory that you can attach there as well. Let me show you how it works. We recommend setting your soldering iron to about 20 degrees above the usual printing temperature. So for PLA, I set mine to 240 degrees Celsius. If the temperature is too low, you will have a hard time removing the insert. If it's too high, you risk decomposing the plastic and generating harmful fumes. While my TS-101 iron is heating up, I install the copper screws included in the set into the inserts I want to remove. I make sure to screw them in at least the length of the insert for good heat transfer. Because the insert remover is made from nickel-plated copper, it needs a bit more time to heat up, so I usually let it sit for another couple of minutes after my iron indicates that it has reached the target temperature. Then I take my soldering iron with the insert extractor installed and hook it under the head of the copper screw. It takes a few seconds for the heat to travel through the screw into the insert, softening the plastic. I keep a slight pull on the screw to ensure good heat transfer and to feel exactly when the plastic becomes soft. After about 10 seconds with PLA, the insert loosens and can be pulled out of the plastic with minimal force. It's really important to be gentle. Pulling too hard can damage the M5 adapter or even worse, your soldering iron. So please be patient. We've tested this on various plastics and I was able to remove every insert after 10 to 30 seconds. We currently only sell the extractor for M3 and smaller because we worry people might break their soldering irons with larger inserts. Still, depending on the feedback from this first batch, we'll consider making bigger versions. And what you also need to keep in mind, our sales data show that M3 is by far the most popular insert size anyway. Once I remove the first brass insert, I just shake off the screw and move to the next one. Our set contains 5 screws in M2, M2.5 and M3, which is usually enough because the one you first removed cools quickly and can be reused at the time you pulled out the rest. We initially thought we could get away with steel screws, but the thermal conductivity is so poor that it would have made this method pretty much useless. That's why we directly include them in the set, but also sell them separately if you need extras. Now let's look at the inserts we removed. Depending on the material, they often come out quite clean. Some might have a bit of plastic residue left on them, so I wouldn't recommend installing them in incompatible materials. For instance, don't reuse inserts from PLA parts in PETG prints and vice versa. However, they can be reused, and even though the holes might look a bit frayed, they are usually still good for reinstalling inserts, at least for prototypes. Just don't expect the same strength and precision you'd get with new inserts and a new part. So, this is one of the new products we've had in the pipeline for quite some time. I've been using it frequently to remove inserts from 3D prints I no longer need, especially those going into my recycling bin, or if I accidentally installed the wrong insert size. If you've been looking for something like this, head over to cnckitchen.store or use the link in the description. This is the best way to support our work here on the channel. Orders above 100 euros ship free worldwide, and if you live in Germany, you'll always get free shipping. And because we know that nothing can be perfect, please share your thoughts on this tool and on removing inserts in general in the comments below. Help us refine our lineup and source the things you truly need. Thanks for watching, and until next time, auf Wiedersehen!